Thank you. Good morning. I'm going to talk about the functional impact of supratotal resection in low-grade glioma. Why do we operate low-grade glioma, as Professor Dufour explained better than I could? We operate low-grade glioma to obtain biological material for the histological diagnosis, to provide symptom relief and improve seizure control, and to change the natural history of the disease. But to have an impact on the PFS, a critical role is played by the extent of resection. As explained several years ago by the group of Berger in this work, which are a group of patients which was possible to obtain gross total resection as longer progression-free survival and overall survival in comparison to a group of patients which only a subtotal resection was obtained. The group of Palud demonstrated the presence of glioma cells outside the MRI abnormalities, and this is maybe the reason why this disease has the tendency to relapse despite a total resection. So Professor Dufour published this work in which he first conceptualized the term of supratotal resection. This is an extended resection far beyond the MRI abnormalities until a functional boundary is reached. And he suggests in this work that the supratotal resection could have a stronger impact on progression-free survival and overall survival in comparison to complete resection. What is supratotal resection is when in the postoperative MR we do not have any residual tumor and the postoperative cavity volume is bigger than the preoperative tumor volume. This is a couple of examples from our series. This is a left insular glioma in which we perform a total resection, another case of total resection. And here, what does it mean, a supratotal resection? As you can see, the postoperative cavity is much bigger than the preoperative tumor volume. And this is feasible in the so-called non-dominant hemisphere, but also in the classical defined dominant hemisphere. So in this context, we designed our study to evaluate the impact on the high cognitive function of the supratotal resection. We look at our series of patients operated from 2011 to 2016. And among about 400 patients with presumptive low-grade glioma, submitted to surgery, we were able to perform a supratotal resection in about a third, so 150 patients. And among those patients, we select, according to the inclusion criteria, those in which were available complete preoperative and postoperative neuropsychological evaluation, and at least a gross total resection was reached. Among those patients, we select 100 of patients that met the inclusion criteria, and we retrospectively divide those patients according to the extent of resection in a total and supertotal group. The two groups were comparable for all the clinical and demographic features that we analyzed, and all the patients included in this study are evaluated with an extensive neuropsychological battery of tests that include more than 20 tests. And for the purpose of this study, we pulled together the neuropsychological tests in five main functional domains that are memory, language, praxis, executive function, and fluid intelligence. And then we evaluate the percentage of pathologic tests inside each functional domain and compare the probability of deficit after surgery in the two population with a general linear model. What we obtain is this kind of chart, one for each functional domain, in which every time point are plotted the probability of a score or of a pathological score for the two group, and the dotted line is the total group, while the solid line is the supertotal. And as you can see, the two groups show a very similar trend during time with an increased percentage of deficit immediately after surgery and a substantial recovery 3 months after. We did not find any statistical effect of resection on the neuropsychological score. And this is, we found the same result for every functional domain. So memory, praxis, executive functions, and fluid intelligence. On a subcohort of 30 patients, We perform the same with a longer follow-up. We perform the same analysis, and in this patient, neuropsychological evaluation 1 year after surgery was available, and this data confirmed the short-term analysis with a similar score 1 year after surgery between the total and supratotal group. Then we evaluate the effect of supratotal resection on seizure control. The two groups were comparable before surgery for percentage of control of seizure and number of anti-epileptic drugs. But after 1 month after surgery, we look at the patient and the patient in which a supratotal resection was feasible was obtained as better seizure control with less anti-epileptic drugs. Finally, we evaluate the oncological impact on a small subcohort of patients. It's a different cohort because we need a long follow-up. Our 52 patients with a confirmed diagnosis of oligodendroastrocytoma grade 2 with at least 6 years of follow-up. We retrospectively divide according to extent of resection in two groups, and the two groups were comparable for the classical demographic and clinical feature. And what we look at the recurrence, we do not see any recurrence in the supratotal group, while 78% in the total group at a recurrence during the follow-up. Obviously, it's a quite short follow-up, but it's a beginning. In conclusion, the supratotal resection, in our opinion, is feasible and safe. We did not observe any difference in neuropsychological score between total and supratotal resection, and it seems to have a stronger impact on progression-free survival, but a proper study with a longer follow-up is needed to confirm these results. Thank you.